Hi everyone. So let's talk about some of the Next.js advanced features before we move to the demo applications. Okay, so these are the one like dynamic loading of components, like lazy suspense exists in React. Similarly, we can use a dynamic next dynamic to load the components dynamically. We can customize the app using underscore app.js, underscore document.js, underscore airpage.js respectively. If you wanted to customize document, create underscore document.js, and you can also customize server by writing your own custom express server, and you can customize the error page if you don't like the 404 page we have, right? So dynamic loading, if we just talk about it, how it works is it is same as the suspense lazy. Okay, here we have hello component and we are getting dynamic from next dynamic. Okay, how we are doing is import this component dot, then if this component is imported successfully, then you do whatever you want. So this is how we are actually creating dynamic component, and once it is imported, you can pass the props and all these things in the same way, like name, if you want to pass hello. Okay, now other thing is you can actually customize the error page, document page and all. So consider that if you have a document page, then inside this you can actually pages, you can create underscore document. Okay, so we can customize underscore document also, like create underscore document page, and here we are using next head. We are getting HTML head, main and next script. So in the head you can actually put whatever you wanted to add in the meta tag. This is the body and next script. So this is how you can customize. Similarly, we have a custom error page which you wanted to create. So currently we have, like, you can define your own custom error page based on the status code you are getting, error.js, and I'm just copying this from the documentation. Based on status code you can actually return and get initial props. I mean, before even this get rendered, we are injecting status code as a props in the error component, right? So status code will be available and we will be able to see is it as a 400, 500 and all. Similarly, you can also customize the app. So you can actually write your own underscore app.js, which we have, I guess, here. If you wanted to pass some page props, then you can use underscore app.js. So you can use it to catch any kind of error coming from the components. So this app.js actually used to initialize the pages. You can override it and control the page initialization process, and a lot of other things we can use is, first of all, we can actually add a global CSS, right? Custom error handling we can do with the help of component did catch. Keeping the state of all the navigation which is happening, we can persist the layout between different pages. All those root level things you can do in the underscore app.js. Okay, and you can actually create a custom server, and custom server looks same. I will just copy it from documentation and I will try to show you. This you can create as a server.js file. So currently we are starting it with the help of next start, right? So in that particular case, if you are using next custom server, then you will be creating server.js somewhere and then you will be running it, right? So consider if I just create server.js, either it is in the pages folder or here. We are just using the HTTP and requiring next. So app.prepare, once the app is prepared, then we are calling create server of HTTP. And here we have just created some custom routing. Okay. So if path name is this, then app.render, it will be taken care by Next.js route path. And if path is not matching with this, then it will go to the handler, right? So handler will just check what is the route, is it matching with the underscore pages folder, page-based routing, and then it will render it. So server.js doesn't go through the Babel and Webpack compilation. We have to just convert our package.json, would look something different if we are going to use it, like something like this. We have a dev build, next build is fine, and for start we have to use node-server.js, for dev also node-server.js. And importantly, what we are doing here is, if you see this, so app object, yeah, so what we are doing is this app object we are getting from the next, and we have created a request handler, and this handler is handling if the path is not matching. So here we can actually write our custom routing logic if we have any external routes to support, and then default it will fall back to the Next.js page based routing. Okay, and here we are listening to the server. Okay, this is how we are creating the custom server, and the package.json will change accordingly for this. Okay, and I mean, if you wanted to, there are different arguments which you can specify that we will see in the demo applications. Okay, so these are the only things which I wanted to talk about. Now let's create a weather application using Next.js in the next video.